Hello and welcome back to the FPGA PS channel. Let's look at the DDR usage in MPSoC devices. As we explained before, the MPSoC integrates programmable logic and processing system components on a single chip. Within the MPSoC, there are two types of DDR. PSDDR. This refers to the DDR memory accessible by the processing system, and it's used for general-purpose computing tasks by the ARM cores. PLDDR. This DDR memory is directly accessible by the programmable logic side. It's typically used for custom accelerators or specialized tasks. PSDDR versus PLDDR. PSDDR. Accessed directly by the APU and RPU units. Used for running applications, storing data, and executing code. Configured through the DDR controller. PLDDR. Accessed by custom logic, implemented in the programmable logic. Often used for high-throughput data processing, custom accelerators, or specialized tasks. Configured using the memory interface generator. Unfortunately, the board is not shipped with the PLDDR installed, but the connector is provided. You need to order a proper DDR and install it on the board, then you can use the MIG to connect the PL to this DDR memory. This is very useful when you need wider bandwidth and more memory for video applications running on PL side. DDR controller in MPSoC devices. The DDR controller, such as DDR4 or LPDDR4, is responsible for interfacing with DDR memory connected to the MPSoC. Let's open the Vivado and show you the DDR controller setup in ZCU104. Primary duties of DDR controller include memory configuration. The DDR controller configures the memory interface based on the specific DDR device used. It sets timing parameters, data rates, and other settings. Data transfer. It handles read and write operations between the processor cores and the DDR memory. Addressing. The controller manages memory addressing, ensuring data is correctly mapped to the physical memory locations. The other duties are timing control, power management, error handling, initialization, and training. Let's close the DDR controller setup and look at an important note about AXI DMA. If you want to send and receive data from PL side into PSDDR, you need to use AXI DMA and provided AXI slave port. If you want to use the MIG example is already provided in the board examples. You can open the board examples tab and then take the MIG example and add it to your IP block design. Other provided memories on the carrier board. As explained previously, there is a 512 megabits QSPI on the carrier board. Its primary usage includes booting and FPGA configuration. You can save the bitstream or boot image in the QSPI. Additionally, you can store a small amount of data for fast access in the QSPI. The SD card also serves two main functionalities. Used as storage for large files, datasets, and application data, and as an alternative boot source to load the bootloader, OS, and application code. For instance, using an SD card allows access to 16 gigabytes of data storage. Controlling and I/O interfaces. The ZCU104 board provides different controlling and I/O interfaces. This controlling I/O interfaces are used for quick change of current mode or displaying the current status without any need to extra hardware. The first one is the user LEDs. The board has four user LEDs, each located near a push button. These LEDs are programmable and can be controlled via the PL side or user push buttons. You can use these LEDs to show few different situations. For example, you can have a blinking LED that after downloading the bitstream it starts to blink, and it shows that the clocks and everything is running properly in your PL side. User push buttons. There are four user push buttons on the board, and also there is one CPU reset. These buttons are connected to input I/O pins of PL side. You can use them for various purposes, such as triggering actions, responding to events, or changing to new situation. User dip switch. The eval board features a four-position user dip switch. This switch is also connected on the I/O pins of PL side of the board. You can set different positions to configure specific behaviors or options. PMBus Interface. Power Management Bus is an open standard protocol that allows communication with power management devices. The ZCU104 development board features a PMBus interface for monitoring and controlling onboard power supplies. You can communicate with power management devices using this interface. For example, monitor the power usage and if it is larger than a threshold, turn off the board. I2C Bus Interface. Based on the provided schematic, the third PMOD on the carrier board is connected to I2C network, and this network is shared between both PL and PS side. You can connect different I2C devices, like LCD or EEPROM, to this port for communication and practicing. Expansion connectors. As we explained before, MPSoC package also contains a lot of I/O pins. The PMOD ports and FMC port make the access to some of these I/O pins. On the carrier board, three PMOD connectors are provided, and those are connected to the PL side. PMOD, peripheral module, is a standard interface used on FPGA development boards like the ZCU104 to connect external peripheral modules. It provides a set of pins and connectors for interfacing with various add-on modules, such as sensors, displays, and communication devices. PMOD connectors enable easy expansion and integration of additional functionalities into FPGA-based projects. Now, let's have a look what PMOD tools are available in the market. You can order with a cheap price, variety of sensors, OLEDs, analog to digital converters, digital to analog converters, and more fun tools. FPGA Mezzanine Card, FMC, is a connector standard on FPGA development boards that provides a compact interface for connecting mezzanine cards. FMC is used for integrating various expansion modules and accessories into FPGA systems. ZCU104 offers a lower pin count than the full FMC connector, while still supporting high-speed data transfer and power. Now, let's look at the different types of FMC connector in provided link. As we mentioned before, the FMC is high compact connector that makes access to a lot of FPGA pins. High pin count HPC. This type of FMC connector has 400 pins arranged in 10 rows, with each row containing 40 pins. It provides access to a wide range of FPGA pins. The connectivity and functionality of pins are explained in this table. Low pin count, LPC. The LPC connector has 160 pins arranged in 4 rows. While it offers fewer pins, it's still useful for specific applications. As you can see in the summary table, FMC connectors support various connections and protocols, including gigabit transceivers, clocks, I2C, and JTAG. Now, let's look which mezzanine card can be attached to the ZCU104. The first one is FMC Loopback XM107. This mezzanine card is designed to test and validate the functionality of FPGA development boards with FMC connectors. It facilitates loopback testing by routing signals from the transmitter channels back to the receiver channels. For example, you can design a gigabit transceiver with one channel, test and validate it with this loopback card, and study IBERT and I-diagram of gigabit transceiver. The second one is AD9361 daughter card. You can convert your evaluation board to a software-defined radio by this Mezzanine's cards. It features the AD9361 RF transceiver, which supports a wide frequency range from 70 MHz to 6 GHz and provides a configurable bandwidth from 200 kHz to 56 MHz. After installation of this card, you can practice wireless communication systems, LTE, Wi-Fi, and other RF applications. If you like to expand your board with more cameras, you can use the Raspberry Pi Camera Mezzanine card. It's an add-on expansion board for FPGA and SoC-based development boards. This Mezzanine card enables the connection of four Raspberry Pi-compatible cameras to the carrier development board. Please note that, for ZCU104, the number of supported cameras is less than four, because there is only 1 gigabit transceiver available on FMC connector. This segment was the second section of the overview. We will continue the overview in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share your ideas in the comments. Thank you for watching.